Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're gonna check out top 3 best point and shoot cameras. Starting at number 3. Ricoh GR3. The Ricoh GR3 is a compact 24MP APS-C format camera with a 28mm equivalent f2.8 lens. The third in a series of APS-C GR compacts from Ricoh, the GR3 has been a long time coming, but updates the GR2 in some highly significant ways. Several Ricoh representatives have described the GR3 to us as a labor of love. Keep reading to find out whether the work of the company's engineers has paid off. The GR3 is a major update to the GR and GR2 that preceded it. The resolution increase from 16 to 24MP was expected, but the addition of sensor stabilization, a touch-sensitive screen, and the removal of the built-in flash make the GR3 a very different photographic tool, albeit one that should feel instantly familiar to GR2 fans. A new addition is a 3-axis image stabilization that gives a 4-stop improvement in the shutter speed you can get away with for handheld exposures. ISO has been boosted to a maximum of 102,400, which will help cement the camera's low-light credentials. Autofocus also now benefits from hybrid AF, using phase detection for speed and contrast detection for accuracy. There is a macro mode that allows you to focus down to subjects in the 5-12 cm range. And you can focus manually too, with such mod cons as focus peaking to help you to do this accurately. Check out the description for more information and latest price. Coming at number 2. Canon PowerShot G7 X3. The Canon PowerShot G7 X3 is the third in a series of one-type sensor compacts aimed at smartphone camera upgraders and enthusiast photographers looking for a small second camera. Its core photography features, notably its fast 24-100mm equivalent f1.8 lens, are very similar to the G7 X2 that preceded it, but Canon has given the Mark III a new stacked CMOS sensor and Digicate processor that together promise better image quality and performance. The biggest changes in the G7X Mark III are to its suite of video features, which now includes the option to live stream video, a useful feature for vloggers. Resolution has been bumped up to 4K, with 30p available out of the box, and 24p coming via a future firmware update. Aside from the lens, the majority of the features highlighted above are new, so the Mark III isn't just a small upgrade, even if it's hard to differentiate cosmetically from its predecessor. It goes without saying that you'll need a solid connection to the internet to make this work. Video is streamed at 6 megabits per second, so a fast home or wireless connection is a must. Since streaming is a big battery drainer, you may want to connect a USB PD compatible power pack or AC adapter to the camera first. And number 1 of this list. Fujifilm X100V. The X100V is Fujifilm's 5th X100 series camera since the original model debuted almost a full decade ago. Through each successive iteration, Fujifilm has made its large sensor prime lens compact camera more and more capable. And this latest model takes the core bits of Fujifilm's high-end interchangeable lens X-PRO3 and slips them into a much smaller package. This means you get the company's latest 26MP X-Trans APS-C sensor and processor combo, the promise of much improved autofocus, and the best video feature set we've seen on a prime lens compact camera. But it doesn't stop there. The lens has been redesigned, the ergonomics refined, the viewfinder revisited, and a whole lot more. The X100 series has always been a favorite among the preview staff, and for some good reasons. These cameras produce wonderful images, they're beautifully designed and are engaging to use. For those that have been eyeing some or other version of X100 over the years but never taken the plunge, this latest model is arguably the one to get. But for owners of previous X100 models, should the V tempt you to upgrade? Let's find out. If you're thinking whether the design affects the accessibility to the camera's controls, then let me tell you that it does, but in a good way. The design features a set of locking dials and levers on the top plate of the camera that make exposure control and shutter speed adjustment super quick and easy. The exposure compensation dial makes room for adjusting +3 f in 1/3 steps. The dial also includes a C position that can afford an expanded +5 f range when working with the command dials. I have included this product links in the description. You can check out this link for more information and latest price. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel, leave a like and share with your friends.